message I want to give is, while we learn English, let's not replace our languages. Let it not be households where we only speak English and we've forgotten our Gujarati, our Marathi, our Tamil, our Bengali, because today we are celebrating incredible India. If you look at the panels over there, we've got the pictures of all the cultural dances, the monuments, etc. But when we, and we are all very proud of being Indian. I have no doubt about that. When I see the way people stand at attention at movie halls for the national anthem, you can feel the pride every time the national anthem is sung. And I'm sure all of you know that the Indian national anthem has repeatedly been elected as the best national anthem, which is thanks to its melody, its rhythm, and its words. All of you know that, and it's something we're all proud of. But somewhere where it bothers me is, while we are proud, we do very little ourselves to promote the very things that we are proud of. Because I know that parents will send their children for tuition classes. In spite of coming to a very good school, parents will struggle to get more money to pay for tuition classes. But very few parents actually send their children to learn, let's say, a classical dance or classical music or an instrument. When I go to school sometimes and I just ask them, there are always pictures of Goddess Saraswati. Now, I'm not really advocating any particular religion, okay? But just for the sake of knowledge, when I ask them, what is the instrument that she's holding? A lot of our students don't even know that she has the veena in her hand. And that is what somewhat bothers me. Whenever we speak of all these wonderful monuments over here, we are all proud of it. But what happens is, if we had the opportunity and somebody gave us a lot of money, we would instantly buy a ticket to go abroad and go to Singapore or America or Europe or somewhere. Because we're more interested in seeing the outside world rather than exploring what we have. And I want to bring to your notice that America is a wonderful country, and we must try and imbibe the good things that all the cultures can give us. But what we must not forget is, countries like America have a history of barely 300 years. India has a history of about 25,000 years. We've got a legacy that has come down to us, which is so good, so strong, that we take it for granted. And unfortunately, it's the cities that we tend to forget what we actually have received. And to me, that's my appeal to all of you, that please, while you are making your child a global citizen, do not remove the Indian in that global citizen. Because India has a lot to offer to the world. We are not superior, but we definitely have a lot to offer. We can make the world a better place with our Indianness. So it doesn't matter whether your mother can speak impeccable English. That's not important. Can your mother communicate the right message, the right values? That's more important than you know. So let's be proud. Unfortunately, we are so apologetic about everything. Oh, you know, my grandmother doesn't speak. She only speaks Gujarati. You know, we are a little dark. We're dark-skinned. We're so apologetic. We have to be so proud of ourselves. Our skin doesn't react so badly to the sun. And we have this wonderful sun. And while I know that you must have classrooms which are air-conditioned, because yes, it makes a lot of good sense, children are more comfortable, remember that if your child and you can actually adjust to the weather around us, that's far more better. When we talk about ecological and environment-friendly things, let's first be environment-friendly ourselves. You know, if you look at the costume, now today is annual day, so children will come in costumes. They will wear the Bengali outfit, the Rajasthani, everything. But we do not give thought to where is all this originating from. If you notice, all these costumes that are specific to an area are there because of the climate, the geography, the seasons that happen over there, and they have been devised over 25,000 years and perfected. That is why you find a Rajasthani out in the desert. He is wearing this colorful outfit with a pagri. Now, the pagri is not simply a topi, okay? It's a pagri. It's an art. It's a kala to actually do the topi, that pagri, because along with protecting him from the heat, it also air conditions him. It allows for air. our homes, we talk about vastu more like a fad. It's a fashion statement. I have my vastu consultant who's telling me how to make my house. It's not vastu, it's just light, air, and free flowing of energy. That's what vastu is. And if you go to our homes, you know, when there was this earthquake at Latur, the things that actually got destroyed were the modern buildings. The local architecture actually did not fail the people. The local architecture is low-roofed, flat-roofed homes for Latur. But no, we want to build glass and chrome everywhere. All our airports, if you look at it, beautiful airports are all glass and chrome. When you go to Aurangabad, you see a glass and chrome airport. You go to Baroda, you see a glass and chrome. There's no individuality. Where is the culture being reflected? It's simply not there. I think you're getting the point. I can talk till tomorrow morning, but I think you're getting the point. So I'm going to end with just two stories. 10 years ago, Bombay had these huge floods, a lot of destruction of property. When one went into the whys, why did it happen? There were two things, because we Bombayites were using a lot of plastic and we did not think of how to dispose it, so we clogged all the sewage systems. The other reason was our very intelligent civil engineers, who must have got 99% or 100% or 103% or whatever it is, the marks that we chase, they got that and they built beautiful roads for Bombay. What they gave up when they were pursuing their percentages, what they gave up was simple common sense. They didn't realize that when you're building a road, you cannot and must not block a river, the mouth of a river. You know, right from those old Bollywood songs that say, Nadi mile sagar se, we all know that the river has to flow into the sea. But here they were, they built these beautiful things and completely blocked the river, and that's what caused the destruction. Think about it. So please, when you parents teach your kids, don't push pressure on them to just get those marks. Because ultimately, every single child, and you will see it today, every single child is born intelligent and beautiful. And whether he gets the 99% or whether he gets 40%, he or she has it in them to do brilliantly. You have such a wonderful school. I have actually watched the school over the last 2 days, not the last immediate 2 days, but once before and once today, because I came early and I was watching the performance before all of you did. And I know the school is doing all it can. But remember, a child spends barely 6 hours in school and 18 hours with you per day. It's the parents and the families that can actually make a child. And these are the memories. When the child is young, when the child is at home, it's the kind of pressures you put and what are the values you teach the child that ultimately will make the child a true Indian global citizen. Thank you so much for listening to me so patiently. Thank you for inviting me. Thanks. Thank you, ma'am. Those words will surely be cherished by us for a lifetime. I once again call our little hosts, Meher and Raghav, to take the program forward.
Thank you, ma'am. You know, our little ones from playgroup are going to begin our show with a dance. So, let's welcome them. Thank you.
Come on, parents, let's see all your hands up. Give them a big hand.